we are already in the studio here. We're going to have a professor here who is here, and we are going to have a lot of things to talk with professor. It's going to be about something that you're having in UMS, right, professor?
Yes, and thank you for the invitation.
Okay, professor. Let me have you. Professor Fong Soon Fook.
Yes.
With the multimedia education at University of Malaysia Sabah, yes. UMS.
Yes.
All right, Prof. Please tell me a bit about yourself first.
Oh, okay. My name is Fong, and my professorship is in multimedia education. I'm attached to the Faculty of Humanities, Arts and Heritage in University of Malaysia Sabah. And recently, I've been appointed to be the coordinator for a project, a new project called as gamification at UMS.
Bro, gamification is a new word to me.
And dalam bahasa Malaysia dipanggil sebagai gamifikasi.
Oh, it's gamificated. Like canggih. I still can't know what it's all about. Please tell us.
Yeah. Okay. So this term. Actually, it originated in somewhere in the year of 2003,
okay.
And recently it became more popular. And in Malaysia, this term was used by our Minister of Higher Education, Dato' Sri Idris Yusof, in his annual message to the public university in the beginning of this year. And he was calling, you know, that our education system needs to be more flexible, he was saying. It needs to be more innovative. We need to be more creative. So that was where he bring in the term. How about we explore gamification for our university education?
Okay.
And that is where our chairman of our board of directors in the UMS, our Tun Jaki. So he says that, okay, this is our response, our university response. So let us explore together.
Is gamification more to do with the millennials, you know, millennials, those who are in the ages of 20 plus and 30s, you know, is it so a lot aimed at them? That
yeah, Kak Zee, you really hit the nail on the head.
Because people like me won't understand what gamification, so I guess when you explain it just now, so it must be for the millennials, right?
Exactly, because the root word of a gamification comes from the word games,
yeah.
And we know that these days, you may easily see that over 90% or 95% of the young people of today play games. And moreover, it is not just playing games on their PC, not playing games on their Mac, but their smartphone. Practically, all students in universities are having their phone. So, they are able actually to get online, and they're playing online games, video games. And there is something about games that is so engaging. There's something about games that is so captivating. They can continue to play at 2 a.m., 3 a.m., and they wake up at 5 a.m. to go for lectures. So, somehow, there's some kind of a priority, some kind of a addiction, you might call it.
Just like the Pokemon thing.
But oh, there you are. Even driving people are trying to catch a Pokemon. You're right. It's pretty dangerous.
It is.
But there is something positive about it.
Okay, so let's look at the positive part of the gaming thing, you know, Prof. You know, people like me, I don't know, I'm not into gaming thing. I love to listen to music in my computer and all that in my YouTube. What is it all about?
Yes, okay. So, but prior to that, I may have to tell you that we bring in the term flexible education.
Okay.
And that is a gamification in this case. All of it is, as you say, in line with the Y generation of today. Okay. They are technology-savvy people, and at the same time, they love challenges. They are not lazy. As long as they are clear with a goal, they are bold, and they dare to explore and to take risks. This is the Y generation.
Mm-hmm.
So, how about, you know, we go in line with actually their strength. So, we hope, you know, that through gamification in the university, then our students are going aligned with their virtues and their attributes. We might be able to bring in deeper understanding of the content that they're learning in all the discipline. Probably able to inculcate, we call it 21st century skills among them.
Okay.
Meaning, they become more creative, they are more critical, okay, they are able to communicate more effectively, and they're able to collaborate as a team player, even as a global player. So that is a background, Kazi.
Yeah, okay.
But with respect to gamification then, probably I can just define it in a very simple way, that gamification is actually using the mechanics of games, the elements of games, okay, the thinking, the game thinking we call it, to engage people, to engage our student, to motivate them into action, not just plan, no, but they go into action. And all in all is to promote effective learning and to promote effective problem solving. That is gamification.
Are you not worried that, you know, they might get, not the Candy Crush thing, but, you know, they might get so immersed in it that they forgot about, you know, the environment outside them?
Surely, Kazi. Once again, that is the worries of parents especially.
Yeah.
And also among educators, yes. You know. So, we once again, you know, there will always be the negative aspect. So, now it is how we as educators, and hence we come into this workshop, you see. Mm-hmm. So, the program, this workshop of gamification at the University of Malaysia Sabah, the whole idea is now to re-educate our lecturers, our professors, you know, our conventional, traditional academician, you know, who will stick to lectures, okay, after all, they are memang tok guru in their own content, and students come to the lecture hall, they will sit down there, no talking, no perbincangan, and they will just continue to take notes, and the lecturer will just go one way, one way. Now, that is conventional, and I'm not saying it's not good, because the tok guru, the sifu must impart those knowledge, those skills into all the students. But there is now, the research is showing that we need to reduce that particular paradigm. We need to reduce that kind of approach. We need to bring in more student-centered learning.
So see, since you said that Tok Guru is also involved in it, or else it's a one-way traffic, right?
Yes.
Do you have to retrain your Tok Guru, you know?
Exactly, Gazi. Hence, we need this workshop.
Yes,
so this workshop is, on one hand, to tell them what is games all about,
yes.
What are the mechanics and the elements of games, and what are the advantages of games that have been captivating all the young people throughout the world.
Yeah.
Now, can we actually use those game elements and put it into our lesson?
All right, one question. Is UMS going to design your game? What you said, it's not gamification.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
Are you going
yes.
to design so that, you know, just like Pokemon, Candy Crush and all these things, that is going to be international, it's going to be global?
Memang itu hasrat kita. Eventually. But for a start, you know.
Okay. This is going to be your baby steps first, right?
We are beginning.
Okay.
Okay, we are exploring. Mm-hmm. So, gamification actually, Kak Z, has got two categories. One category is, we call it serious game. And there's
what game? Say again?
Serious game.
Oh, serious game. Okay.
Those video games.
Yes.
All right. Those we call it massive online role-playing games where people come in and they are having their members in the clan, in the groups, and together, you know, they go about to invade certain territory. They go about to get certain weapons so as to defeat the enemy. So there's some kind of defeating enemy, shooting enemy. Those are negative, of course, but they have strategies. Actually how to overcome certain halangan, certain obstacles, you know. And that brings in actually critical thinking among them, how to do problem solving within the game. We want to actually bring this element, these strategies, this problem solving, this motivation into our academic courses. Mm-hmm. So we need to train our lecturers. Okay, concerning this, how to actually have this knowledge and this background, these skills, and how to integrate it within our course.
Yeah. You know, Prof, I think not only the lecturers need to be
retrained.
Parents too, you know.
Oh, yes.
Parents, you know, because we were not, we are from the, I don't know what generation you call us.
Okay, baby boomers.
Yes. The baby boomers, a different generation from them.
Uh-huh.
And we are worried, even a three-year-old, you know, they'll be holding that from morning until night. And the moment you take it away from them, they'll be screaming.
Oh, yes.
Okay, how the millennial babies who are now mothers have to cope with this? You know, if they are a professor, if they are a lecturer in the university, fine. Yes. But if they are just lay people like us,
yes.
How do you control this?
Yes.
I wouldn't like to use the word control. How do you manage this?
How do you manage it? Yeah, exactly. So, with respect to the video games, those popular games, you know, those Warcraft, those Clash of Clans, those Candy Crush. By the way, Kazi, what game do you play?
Me? I don't play any games at all, but I listen to music. But there's the fact, say, you know, I can't even say.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Anyway, I love music, so.
I hope that by the end of this session, I'll be able to bring you over into the world of games and have another totally world of fun altogether.
I'm more of a reading person, you know. I can read and read and read the whole library, you know.
Ah.
When I was young, I remember the whole primary school library. I can read it within a couple of months.
Oh, wow. That's, okay. So now. Yeah.
Into games, right?
Right. So, concerning games, those games, as you say, it will continue to grow in popularity. And there's no running away.
Mm.
Okay? So, what we want to do as academic, as in the world of education, is actually to, as you put it, design and to develop our own games. Okay? Whereby, there are no knife inside there, there are no bullets, there are no guns there, but actually, we call it problem-based learning, project-based learning. So, you know, they go into the virtual world. For example, our students from Sabah. So, they go and meet the different... They go in as avatars. That means, you know, they are represented by certain figures inside there. Then they will meet their counterparts. That means students from Australia who are in the form of avatars again. Okay? You know, those figures that are walking around, you know, in the 3D world.
Mm-hmm.
So, then they will be able to actually look at certain... issues, certain problems, okay, and then probably be able to bincang, to discuss together, to strategize together, to brainstorm together, and who knows, they might be able then to go back into the real world in Sabah, collect the water samples, check up what is the pH, check up, you know, certain situations concerning the pollutants that is in the air of Sabah compared to those in Beijing, in China, you know, and in London. Then they come back into the world, into the 3D world.
Yeah, okay. Into so the real world, I call it.
Yeah, so that is not the virtual world, the real world.
Okay.
And by the way, to the young people, the virtual world, Kazi, is as real as the real world.
I know.
We have to recognize that.
Yeah, we do. You know, and that's why I say we need to be educated too.
Exactly.
Right? Parents need to be educated. My generation needs to be educated because we don't understand why you are so fully into it that you even forget lunch.
Ah, wow. There you are.
You forget your friends.
No, only lunch, only makanan. Terlupa tidur.
You know, they can go into and they'll be blurry eyed. And that's how we be in cahoots with them.
Exactly.
We want to be with you. We don't want to be against you.
Exactly.
All right? So that we can be together. You are in a bus, you know, everybody is different ages and all different skin colors.
Yes.
But
yes.
We are in tandem.
Exactly. That's why I think you bring in a very important point. You know, what about the parents? So that's where the parents need to actually co-work, you know, together with the academician, with the teachers in the school, and to know and to recognize that this game element, there are certain positive values to it. So we want to actually harvest those values and try to impart it into our lesson.
Yeah. So you know, it's going now. Now it's 80%,
yes.
You know, that we try to understand. The 20%, we are in a blur world. Make us alive in that 20%, Prof.
Yes.
My generation.
So, yeah. But, Kazi, you know, games doesn't mean just digital world, you know. It doesn't mean just the virtual world, you know, the 3D world, using technology, using computer and smartphone. Games can also be board games. By the way, have you played Monopoly before?
Oh, I love Scrabble sometimes.
Scrabble, Monopoly.
Okay. But it can make you forget. The bosses are there. If you are still playing Monopoly in the game in the office, you know.
Exactly.
And then we were given a memo.
Oh, yes.
Stop it. I hope gaming, you know, is not like that.
Yes. But anyway, for example, we take just a traditional game. The conventional board games, example Monopoly and Scrabble. So you see, within the game, and compared to the digital world, you know, the virtual world games, actually they have something in common. there are certain elements in common. So example, you know, there is a goal, okay? There's a mission. You need to win. You need to save something, okay? So, and there are rules. And the rules actually become a limitation. You can only try, you know, 3 times. Otherwise, you know, you'll be defeated and you'll kick off the game. You can only pick only 5 pieces, not 3, not 10, you know. So there are constraints, there are rules. And Kazi, all the rules is actually meant to make the game more challenging.
Okay, but you are playing it alone.
Okay, so there are games, you know, where it is one-to-one,
yeah,
okay, with the system.
Pokemon, but you're alone, okay?
Yes, but there are more than that.
Yeah, okay.
You know, there are those that they have to be in a clan, they call it.
Oh, hence because the clan. They are, you know, in touch with people outside, the
That's
international
right.
crowd,
and they
right?
group together.
Yeah, okay.
And then they have the same interest, same motive, they synergize to overcome a particular obstacle.
Yes,
together.
I found only that in the house they are alone.
There you are. So in the virtual world, in their real world, yeah, they are having their companion there. And having said that, you know, of course, as parents, we are concerned. Hey, who are those friends of theirs, their virtual friend? So memang, that is why, you know, we need to create our own system. We need to create our so-called own kokot. Not Pokemon Go, but our own, you know, UMS Go, whatever.
Okay, I was thinking that, you know, we want to join you.
Yes.
We want to join the millennial babies. We want to join you. You know, we don't want to be your enemy.
Yes.
Make us understand.
Yes.
Make my generation understand.
Yes.
You know, not scold you when you argue tightly with your friends
yes.
online.
Yes.
And here we are shouting, you go take your bath. You know?
Yes, yes, yes. And they are the future leaders, you know?
Yes, you know.
We're going to say goodbye one day. Huh. So, there is something about them, these Y generation people, you know. They are risk takers. They are bold, okay? They lead, as you say, you know, they play games. So, from that itself, you know, they pick up those behaviors of being daring. They know that, you know, they can try.
Yeah.
They fail. Mm. They try. They try this way. They fall. Try again.
Yeah,
just try again.
And they
are
know
not afraid.
The risk, yeah? They are not afraid of risk. And
That's
they
right.
dare. You know, dare.
And they overcome by after thinking, you know, creatively and critically, different strategies apply, and they overcome. And that is actually the people we want in the 21st century workforce.
Okay, from my observation, you know, from in the 70s and the 60s and all that, compared to the millennials now,
oh, yes.
okay, not even, really? Even the three-year-old, they are so far advanced
oh, yes.
into their thinking, into yes. their behavior, and you know, they are, I think they are very, very much smarter than all of us.
They are so much smarter than all of us?
No, I mean, they are smarter than, because maybe we have the experience, right?
But yes.
Unless you join them.
Exactly.
Like me, you know, as a grandma and all that, I have to join my grandchildren.
Yes.
Understand which one you are.
Oh, yes, yes.
I mustn't say, hey, stop it, stop it. You know, you will upset them.
Hmm.
You know, just like when we, before, you know, our parents were not understanding, and you know, everything you have to go to the farm. We don't want to go to the farm.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yes.
I think it is the same generation.
It's happening to us.
Generation. So, Prof, what about this program? Please tell us more about it.
Yeah. So this program, in USM, we invite 2 consultants. One from USIM, University.
Islam.
USIM, yeah.
Yeah, USIM.
In Semenanjung. Mm-hmm. And another, his name is called Professor Rozahan Idrus. Okay. He's a CIO in USIM and also the director of a center that actually support the academic staff in the use of technology to enhance their teaching and learning.
Okay.
So he's a very important man. Another one we have is Professor Matya Dr. Tan Wee Ho. He's from UPSI, Tanjung Malim, Perak.
Mm.
Okay. And his PhD is in the area of games. So we have these 2 experts, 2 consultants, 2 facilitators who will come to run the 2 days workshop. And this workshop will be, the participant will be our academic staff. And they come from every faculty, every institute in our university, because we believe that everyone must be involved. So they will form the core group. And within the core group, they will you know, pick up the knowledge, the skills, the concept concerning what is this thing called game-based learning, and this thing about how to gamify the academic courses. You know, perubatan people, engineering people, pharmacists, they will learn how to gamify their courses. And we hope that through this way, our students, you see, the main outcome of our project is finally to benefit our main key stakeholders. And Kak Z, they are our students.
All right. For you, Prof, personally, was it an easy, you know, flow into this gamification thing? Or because you are from a different generation from the students, right?
Yes.
What are the halangan? What are the barriers that you faced through? Or you didn't have any problems at all transforming from, you know, the norms of reading your books instead of gaming? How did you do it?
This is a very good question, Kazi. I've been a school teacher since 1978. Okay, I'm a science teacher, and actually, I was teaching in my last school in Sekolah Menengah Dato On in Butterworth in Penang. Okay, what happened was that by the time when I got my children, so I'm still a teacher, not having a computer at home at that moment. So my wife was telling me, hey, I want my children, my kids, that time they were just 3-4 years old, you know, and my wife somehow see the values of computer. They say, hey, you go and pick up computer and go and teach our children. I see great potential in this. I say, hey, mana boleh. Anyway, you can never beat the ladies. The moment they give the order, you have to follow.
Order, okay.
So eventually, I bought the Apple IIe at that time. Okay. And during that time, because you buy it by importing it from Taiwan, you know, to that area. And I remember it's about 4,000 ringgit Malaysian, quite expensive. Okay, having said that, I couldn't have a breakthrough. So my wife, you know, say, hey, how about you go and do your master? Dalam bidang apa? Dalam bidang komputer. No, lagi hebat ni.
I think that was a change in your life at that time.
Exactly.
Were you afraid? Were you protesting against it? Were you not for it?
Kazi, I'm a baby boomer. Just like you, you know. So we have our conventional way, our comfort zone.
Absolutely.
What is this called computer, you know, the digital world? So all in all, again, I went to week to do my master, and having my education background, so it was actually pretty easy for me to just move into it. You see that there is another paradigm, another approach actually to learning by using computers. And that was how actually I got into the world of pendidikan multimedia.
It means you are not a big, huge protester, you know, because you are doing it. What about parents who are not from the village and all that, you know? They find it is a hindrance. Okay, like me, you... This is our job, so we have to embrace it.
Exactly.
We cannot push it away.
Yes.
But what about those, you know, how do you make them understand that this is important? You must not go against your millennial babies or even the younger children.
Okay. You've got a very good question, Kak Z, because your question bring back, you know, my memory about what I was doing actually in Penang. Okay? Even though I'm here now, okay? But my experience over there...
I'm leaving it, okay?
You're leaving it! Yeah, wonderful!
Okay.
Wonderful!
All right.
So what happened, you know, is that there was concern, you know, the time when in Penang, so the Penang State Education Department saying that, okay, we want to introduce more computers to all the schools. But the problem is, will the parents, you know, support us?
Absolutely, that is the question.
Okay, so what
they are looking at the negative parts of it.
Exactly.
80% negative and 20% maybe. Okay, all right.
Yeah, because, you know, they would distract them away from their real studying, you know, their books and so on. So there was concern. So there was a strategy. What we did was we prepared some wonderful educational programs, and then we go from district to district, and during the night time, we invite parents to come to the school, and we have roadshow. So there, you know, we show them examples of actually how people benefit from using computer-based learning at that time. Not games at that time, you know.
It was, of course not. At that time, it was just usage.
Yes.
You know, hands-on thing.
Yes.
You know, how when you type your things, we used to use Blanco, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Click. Salah sikit. Oh.
Exactly. So... how during that time, you know, the transition from typewriter. I never said the word typewriter since long ago.
No, but no, I mean, I think I don't think the millennials now know what typewriter is all about.
Ayoyo. So this typewriter, okay, has now been obsolete.
Yeah,
okay,
obsolete.
Just
yeah.
because of the world of computers. And hence, you know, we bring in gamification. Not that the different pedagogy means, you know, the different approaches to teaching and learning in the school, in the classroom. It will not go away because we still need, you know, the physical teachers to be in the classroom. But gamification could come in to support, okay, as a supplementary and complementary. You bring in better learning, enhance deeper learning, bring in, we call it higher order thinking skills among our students.
Yes. You know, Prof, at my age, I marvel at the computer. I want anything that I want to know, even sometimes that I've never heard of the word. You click it on Google, whatever they are. You know, I think for those who are against it, I mean, parents are against it because of ignorance.
Sure. So, no, but at the same time, you know, there are real concern because of the negative effects, you press a rock link, you know, you go to some negative sports, you know. Yeah, and that's not too good for our children.
And
some extremists are there.
Yes.
Okay, so we've got to be cautious. Yeah.
So what is your hope, UMS, what is the hope for the people of Sabah as in general on this gamification thing?
Yes. So with this workshop, you know, our outcome is that we start with our lecturers, our candidate, okay, and then through them, they will influence and have a positive impact on our students, our graduates, okay? And through our graduates, one day they graduate, they become teachers or they go into industry, they apply gamification in their, not only teaching and learning, you know, but in their professional development, in marketing, in industry, okay?
So we can be at par with... we are going into a developed world, right? But
yes.
We will be at par with the developed world sooner than we expected. Do you think so?
Well, I believe very strongly, Kazi, you know, that gamification could be one of the strategy that, as Tun Jaki say, you know, we should explore it and we should try to understand it and even come up with products, you know, of gamification and share it not only to the world of Sabah, to Sabah, but to the whole world.
Yeah.
So we are actually becoming global players. And memang, you know, I've been here for 1.5 years in UMS in Sabah. I can see that our students here are really talented. It's so rich, you know, in budaya, in cultures. They're so rich in the native music. They are so talented in the arts. Now, how could we just gamify all this? Okay, and why not share their gamified products with the world?
Yeah, the Sumazawa, and I'll make it a game.
Oh, yes.
You know, that the bamboo dance, you know.
Oh, yes.
You have to make it. You know, that bamboo dance is so fascinating for me. If you turn it into a gaming, or gaming thing, you will conquer the world.
Hey. What kind of game would you call that, Tazi? I think we can team up together. Hey, yes. We design... And I developed.
Yeah, you know, I've been so fascinated by the native dance.
Yes.
You know that.
Those bamboo, yeah.
Oh my God, you can break your leg.
Oh, yes.
If you combine it together,
yes.
Gamification,
yes.
And the art of doing that dance,
yes.
Can you imagine the scope that you will get through? You see, I'm more excited than you are now.
Okay, it calls for you to retire and set up a company and you can employ me.
But I congratulate you, MS, because
oh, yes.
I think this is a pioneer thing, right?
Oh, yes.
This is the first time that a university is doing this thing.
We are, Upsi in Tanjung Malim is
okay.
Also doing it, but at the university level, where all faculties are involved, I think UMS is taking the first lead in Malaysia.
I'd like to congratulate UMS, because UMS have leaps and bounds. I remember the first time that I interviewed one of the leaders, and he said, Tun Mustafa wanted to set up a Sabah University.
Those days,
30 years ago.
Oh, yes.
I interviewed this person. He said, one day we're going to have a university of our own.
Oh, yes.
And Tun Mustafa said, I'll give you a piece of land on the hill facing the sea.
Hey, there is UMS.
There is UMS. And you are a part of it now.
Oh, and I thank you. Yeah, and I thank the people of Sabah that, you know, I can be here, part and parcel of the future of UMS.
Yes. And I love it that you are in the studio here, because it is, has been such an opener for me. who is not a gamification person.
Yeah, I hope you're bought in.
I am, great. And I feel so great to have you, Prof, here. We have a few more minutes more. Is there anything else that you'd like to say? I'll play you a song first. I'm sure you're going to enjoy this, because I like the Scorpion number.
Thank you.
All right, we're still Sabah VFM, your V-Good channel. I said radio has no voice. Radio has no face.
Ah, that's right.
Nobody knows how old I am.
Oh, yeah.
So it has no face. They think you're a very young professor.
V-Good.
Alright, so your V-Good channel, you're with Kazi in the studio with Professor. You're still here with me, Professor Fung.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, Prof. We had a great time today, and learned a new word today, and that is gamification. I'm glad you're here today.
Oh, yes.
And we've got around 8 more minutes before we cross over to Tracks FM for the national news.
Yes.
What more can you say? You were talking about what the song was playing, that it is important that schools, that teachers are being aware of gamification.
Yes.
Tell us more about it.
Yes. It's true, you know, that in the world of education, teachers on the whole, of course, will be concerned, because games naturally distract students from their homework, naturally distract them, you know, from so-called their curriculum, normal curriculum, formal teaching and learning.
Mm.
But we have to recognize that these games have got certain elements that can engage them, can motivate them, can make them better problem solvers, able to make them think creatively and critically. So can we now exploit and use these elements, these game elements, in our teaching and learning? So this particular project that we have in the UMS, we hope that this is a beginning. And later on, we will have some papers and some reports, and we hope to share it not only to among ourselves, but also to all the other public universities and private universities in the whole of Malaysia and to the world, actually. Mm-hmm. And even more, we want to actually share it with the schools, from the kindergarten, the nursery, the kindergarten, the primary school, the secondary schools. They need to understand actually the values, of how gamification can come in to enhance teaching and learning among our students.
Okay, Prof, it has to be a holistic thing.
Oh, yes.
You know, professors, teachers, students, the children.
Yes.
And we must not forget the other element is the parent.
The parents, that's the parent. Right.
So through PTAs, we have PTAs.
That's right.
Because most of the parents, grandparents that I know are always complaining about their grandchildren and their children. Oh, I don't understand, they get up in the morning, I don't know how to get rid of them. Okay, get rid of the things, their iPod, iPads and all that. How do you educate? You're fine as educators with your lecturers, with your professors, with your students.
Yes.
But the other element, which can break, 20 or 10% elements, how do you embrace them?
Yes.
Bring it into your fold.
Yes, yes. So, other than the conventional popular games that is ruling the whole world among the young people, we as educators and the researchers, I call upon everyone who are interested to come in to design and to develop those game-based learning meant for education. How could mathematics, be acquired through games? How could they learn biology, physics, and all other subjects through games? So we need to actually design and develop. Then we test it out through research, At the same time, we will then do a roadshow and show it among the PTA, as Kak Zee has mentioned. They are the most important people to help enhance actually the use of games in teaching and learning eventually. We have to buy them in. We have to buy in the parents. Then the parents, we need the roadshow.
Yes.
So that's where I think the academies, the universities, the schools, you know, can co-work with the parents in this way.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe even how the design and development, bring in all the key stakeholders actually in the design and development. And in also inculcating the budaya, you know, of Sabah, you know, and everything else.
Okay, Prof, do you have a time frame to achieve this?
Oh, yes. Even this workshop that we are having, we expect that our academic staff is able to implement it within the month. Okay, having understanding, and then within 2 months, they probably will have to give us the report. And together, we would collect the report and we would share it. We will share it.
Mm-hmm.
So, do contact us, you know, at our university website. And I come from faculty, we call it Faculty Kemalusiaan Ansin Lidang Warisan. You just type UMS, FKSW, you should be able to come to our website and we will have something there for you.
Prof, can you repeat that?
Huh?
The
okay, yeah. So, you know, our website in UMS is www.ums.edu.my, okay, /FKSW. Again, ums.edu.my/FKSW.
All right. We
welcome you.
Thank you so much, Professor Fong Soon Fook.
It's been an honor and a pleasure.
And it's an honor for Sabah to have you here.
Oh, yes.
Also an honor because UMS is one of the pioneers of the gaming culture.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Oh, yes.
UMS is going to be great. Professor is going to be great.
Yes.
And all of us in Sabah is going to be great.
Yes.
Thank you so much for listening in. Thank you for being here with me for the last 40 minutes. And
yes.
Thank you.
And we thank our chairman, Tun Jaki, our vice chancellor. Uh-huh. Dato' Harun, okay, and our TNCA, Professor Kamaruddin, my Dean, Professor Ismail, they are actually the champion in gamification. Thank you.
I know, UMS is great.
Yes.
Your last word, Prof.
Many passionate people.
Yeah, passionate people.
Yes,
you.
The word is.
UMS boleh.
Yes, keep the fire of passion burning. Keep it burning through gamification.
Gamification,
yes.
Thank you so much.
Sure, thank you.
Island Hopping is just 20 minutes away. 92.7 FM in Kota Kinabalu.